with this till I come. Not have fun with this. Luke 19 verse 13. Do business. He said, occupy till I come. Do business with this till I come. It takes a serious approach to secure a glorious result. Do business with this till I come. And blessed is the man whom his Lord, when he comes, shall find so doing. Not shall find so playing. Shall find so doing. So get out of here and separate yourself from playboys and playgirls. And tell yourself, I refuse to settle with you. I am an eagle. I refuse to be mistaken for a duck. I'm an eagle. I refuse to be mistaken for a duck. I am an eagle and I refuse to be mistaken for a duck. This Bible in my hand is my 28th Bible in my short journey. And when I say my Bible, I mean where you sit, you know it's my Bible. I write all kinds of stuff inside. And when we're talking anything, I'll go up down and say, okay, 1987, I had this one. Then I pluck it out. And I show you exactly what the Lord told me there. And you see the date there with your eyes open. When my office, I'm talking something there. And I say, okay, reach out for my diary, 1982. And I brought it out and opened the page. Look at this. 1992, this date, this happened. Life is business. Don't watch your destiny go bankrupt. Begin to make adequate investment into your future. Don't wake up and be loitering around. You are too much for that. You are not an injury. You are too much for that. You are too much for that. You are not the kind of person that will say, we are sick until we don't even know he has gone. That's how he goes. He has gone. This is when he's coming back. Ah, nobody can tell. 11, 12, 1. He's a megad. Don't be that irresponsible. Don't be deceived that you are young. People at the age of 8 ascended throne in Israel. At the age of 16 ascended the throne in Israel. You are getting too old for the thing. So wake up and stop playing fun. Stop having fun. 3 days can change your entire world of serious sitting down and say, look, there must be a way out of here. There's a world of difference, like I said, between schooling and learning. Schooling is but for a period of time. Learning is for a lifetime. Amen. Say with me, there is nothing new under the sun. There is nowhere I'm going that somebody has not been there before. So help me to locate, Lord, the mentors on my way that will monitor my steps to the throne. There is nothing new under the sun. There is nowhere I am going that someone has not been there before. There is no calling on my life that someone has not received before. You see, when you understand that, it will help you in reaching out. It will help you in reaching out. It will help you in reaching out effectively, committedly, dedicatedly. There are books I lay hold upon, and when I read something inside it, I go, this is something. Lord, I thank you for this. I read a book many years ago, The Power of Positive Thinking by Norman Vincent Peale. It opened the ceiling of my mental faculty. I read a book about 32 years ago titled Like a Mighty Wind by Bentari, the story of the revival in Indonesia. It opened up my understanding to the reality of the supernatural in the present day, the continuity of the apostolic age. I read the book, The Apostle of Faith, a book written on Smith Wigglesworth. It gave me a superiority mentality over all principalities and powers. I saw myself as being empowered to determine what happens in any conflict. I read a book by T.L. Osborne 30 years ago, titled The Purpose of Pentecost. It healed me of spiritual deafness, and I heard the voice of God direct. And from that day, I've been hearing that voice saying, this is the way, walk in it. I read that book in one sitting. Come and say one sitting. That's when you become an addicted learner. I sat down, I couldn't stand up. I was engrossed. I stretched my back, I won't stand. I read it through from page one to the last, and I stood up like a whirlwind. So it's all you. You will determine what happened. Listen, as a growing up boy, when other boys were all on the streets playing, I would march my way to a primary school during holidays, in the secondary school, and sit down there reading all kinds of literature to enhance my communication acts. Because I know that whatever thing you are going to do in this world, you will need to be able to communicate effectively. You can't eat your cake and have it. There is no free lunch in life. Ignorance is a disease, a killer disease. All we gather in school is literacy. We now apply the literacy in searching for relevant information in line with our calling. It's all literacy. The real task is outside. May I at this point mention the story of Rotimi Williams, the legal legend that is God. He had one dangerous sense of responsibility that he was never found going up and down here and there. He was so focused on making a mark in his practice. No wonder he ended up becoming Timmy, the law. He became the custodian of the legal system of a whole nation because of an unusual commitment in the pursuit of his career. The choice is yours. While I give testimonies of vibrant believers, we give testimonies of men in the secular system to get you angry. If someone that does not have an understanding of his covenant rights could fly so high, why am I here? You are here, you are there where you are because who won't do what you should do? Where you